Good morning, John. It's amazing when you think about it that no one was seriously hurt in this incident. You can take a look. You can see the hole in the roof that the explosion ripped. Now, the man felt the urge to jump into action with 20 to 30 foot flames shooting from the truck.
I'm just glad no one got killed or badly injured.
It was like a scene from a movie, but for Bill Flint, it was reality, as Flint got behind the wheel of a burning tanker truck and drove it out of a building. It began with an explosion. That's when Flint ran toward the truck, knowing another mechanic was inside the building.
I honestly thought he was going to be dead when I went in there.
The mechanics had been working on the tanker, and most had stopped for lunch. But one of them kept banging away, trying to get a valve off the truck. It's not clear if that caused the problem, but in the next few minutes, an explosion blew a 15-foot hole in the roof.
Everything just rumbled and shook, and dust flew and things flew. Debris came down from up in the air.
Across the street, people ducked to avoid flying metal.
I drove a car up the driveway, and I stopped right here. And I was just getting ready to shut it off, and when I opened the door, that's when the explosion occurred, and then I just laid down on the ground because I thought the projectiles were coming through the side of the doors.
Flint arrived at the burning truck in time to see the other mechanic pulling himself to safety.
There were no real physical signs of any injury other than just the two scraped up knees.
As the truck burned, Flint grabbed the keys and moved the truck, fearful that more explosions could damage the building. Firefighters kept pouring water on the tanker for hours to keep it from flaring up. The building was damaged, but no one was seriously injured, and it left Flint with quite the story to tell.
I called her and told her, I'll talk to you later, but whatever you hear or see, everybody's okay.
The man who was caught under that tanker did end up in the hospital, but he was treated and released late Monday afternoon. And the Department of Environmental Services was also here. They checked out the site and determined there was no environmental contamination. Reporting live in Hooksett, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.